You've spoken to some length about why there's been a rise in Islamic extremism in particular, and the reason why they are committing such atrocities, but what do you think the appropriate way is to deal with it? And if it's not through war or violence, then do you not recognise there would be a pretty massive public backlash following the decision to stop bombing or to stop sending troops into Syria and the like?
Yes. Here we see politics and religions coming, you know, head-to-head tussle. You see, there are two aspects that I continue to promote to try and, if you like, water down or reduce this risk or this kind of issue about violence in the name of religion. And again, I mentioned them at our question time. The first issue that comes out of Hinduism which can help or aid the process is called pluralism. There are many different ways you can be spiritual. Allow the individual, doesn't matter whether he's born as a Hindu or a Jew or a Christian, allow the youngster to develop the idea of spirituality in the mode that suits his own temperament. It can be theistic. Oh, I like monotheism. Good for you. Go for it, my boy. Oh, no. It can be non-theistic. I'm a Buddhist. I don't know what a God. Good for you. Oh, it may be saying no, seeing God in humanity. That's Hinduism too. Not in heaven and all these tinkling bells. That too is good. But the most important thing that comes out of pluralism is you can be spiritual without reference to a religion. Because religions come with baggage. Every religion, a lot of baggage. We carried forward for thousands of years. They carry baggage, a lot of nuisance, a lot of nonsense, a lot of superstitions. So we are saying that this evolution is saying you can be spiritual in a non-religious mode. So be it. This is the one idea that can immediately diffuse the issue of killing or converting people in the name of religion, because this is his way, this is my way. So allow people of different traditions, a different method of understanding spirituality, to promote their own ideas in their own way and live their lives accordingly. So be it. Don't interfere.